to teach the pre-Twinkle teaching points. So, Irem, why don't you start us off?
Okay. Shall I tell all of it?
No, the first group of subjects you would approach.
Me?
The first group of things that you would do, yeah. What would you do at the beginning?
Okay, so concert position,
mm-hmm.
which I didn't write, but I
yeah.
concert position and put the violin very gently.
Good, well done.
Bow and teach the parts of
mm-hmm.
the violin.
Great.
And after that, rest position comes.
Yeah, and
rest position feet and playing position feet.
Great, I'll stop you there. Very good, well done. Jeff?
You said concert position feet and rest position feet.
Mm-hmm.
Then the rest position, we then without the violin.
Good.
Bow hold for the kids and the parents as well. Then
great.
After they're doing it alone, so everything else. That should be.
Yeah. Stop the traffic.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes.
And
great.
And then I said go through the rhythms, the scrubbing, the drawing, clapping.
Soaping, not scrubbing.
Soaping, drawing and clapping the rhythms.
Great, well done. Stop, thank you, Sarah.
Then making a bow hold yourself.
Yep, great.
We've done stop with traffic, so they can do the. So, making the bow hold while you're in rest position.
Yeah,
brilliant. To bring it round to the other side.
Yeah, great.
And then getting into stop with traffic position with the bow hold.
Fantastic.
And then the helicopter, that way you go off and hit your hand.
Great.
Which I love.
And how would you do that first?
They would. Oh, I forgot about pop.
Yeah, pop is one of those things we can put in. I mean, you know, I said broad brush strokes, so
yeah.
Pop is definitely part of learning how to put the violin up.
Oh yeah.
But I wouldn't say that it was a mistake to miss it out. We're talking very general terms. Good. So just
you're holding. So basically, I'm just trying to think about it. So you've got the bow hold one hanging there. And
yeah.
You make the bow hold and get into stop the traffic, and then go up, get the person. You stand there with your hand.
Yeah, so all of the things that you teach that are new, you want to simplify as much as possible.
Mm-hmm.
So you teach the bow hold, they learn how to hold the bow. You teach the violin position, but without the bow hold. Then you put them together.
Yeah.
So you've taught them how to get the bow hold ready and the violin up.
Mm-hmm.
But before they then learn how to land the bow, they do the helicopters on the shoulder.
Oh.
So they've practiced this bit, so then when you add all the violin part, it's not... You know, you're reducing the number of new things that you can.
Yeah.
Great. So now we're up to they can get themselves on the E string.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
And then.
Yeah, and do it in order: feet first, and then bow, and
yeah.
then violin.
Brilliant.
They learn that order.
Yeah. Good.
And then E string first. They put their left hand on the wooden part.
Yeah, on the shoulder.
On the shoulder.
Good. Yeah.
They are playing twinkle variations on E string only.
Yes, how at the beginning?
Everybody down up first.
How?
How at the beginning?
The first time you teach them everybody down up, what do you teach?
Because they said already all the other
mm-hmm.
things.
Yeah.
So on E string, they will learn how to put the bow on E string.
Yeah.
And then without holding the violin.
I don't like this.
This.
I find it's fine for them
okay.
to hold it.
Oh, okay.
When they're playing.
All right.
Just check. This is for me, some teachers disagree. For me, having the violin up and playing a lot without it
mm-hmm.
is too much pressure. For them to hold the violin perfectly all the time. I think it's okay for them to have that violin hand here, but you want to check regularly. Give me a wave, tap your tummy, whatever. So it's a balance.
Okay. So on
but the first time they play busy, when you teach them busy, busy, stop, stop, what are you actually teaching them? Because busy, busy, stop, stop means many different things to us, doesn't it? It means all the way through. It means.
So there's a route for the ball is
great.
Going.
Yeah.
For it to be straight.
Good.
It can be a sticker on the
violin. It can be.
And
the stickers are really helpful for the parents. The most places you can put a sticker, the child cannot see it unless they go like this.
What you mean, stick on the violin to show the
where the
road?
Yeah, where track two is. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Because the bridge is in the way.
Yeah.
If they're looking here, that's why they want to go like that.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So they have to see the distance from the bridge on the string of the bow.
Yeah.
They're following middle of their bow. They'll be in the middle.
Are they in the middle?
Yes. I mean, if you.
Where are they starting?
Three.
Where are they starting?
So, this is the heel, middle point, they're starting
where?
In the middle.
No.
No?
Where
this
is the
heel? How do you start on this ball?
Where do we start all of our twinkles?
Yeah, that's...
Where? What's it called, Irem?
It's he. What do you mean? So, the balancing...
Yes! Where we start all of the bow strokes for all of the twinkles and quite a few pieces after. Good. So balance point, and they start at the balance point. And what do they do the first time you teach it to them? What will you do, and what will they do?
What?
The first time you teach busy, busy, stop, stop.
Mm-hmm.
What will you do? Can you either describe or show me? What are you expecting them to play the first time they try it?
Just the correct rhythm on the bow?
Yes. How many times?
I will play the whole busy, busy, stop, stop, twinkle, and they will play with me, for example.
The first time they ever try it?
They have, okay, first me, then you, copy me.
Thank you.
Okay, yes.
Excellent. First time, one at a time.
Yeah.
Probably you do their bow with them holding.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have your violin out?
Yes.
Sorry. So first time we have done all the stop the traffic, check the bow hold, bloody, 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 blah. And we go, okay, you know how to do it on your arm. It's going to feel the same. Can you have a try? Ready? Go. You're such a good student. You don't need any lessons. Go away. So one time, you do it for them.
I do it for them, and they do it on their own.
Yes, and then you can play it on yours, and they can copy.
Yes.
Because even that is more difficult, right? Because
yes.
They don't feel you doing it for them.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And then, very good. And then what's the next stage?
Next stage, I will play whole twinkle.
No.
Oh, okay, so
okay.
Just everybody down that part, and they play with me or pull string.
No, okay, do you have your book one? Oh no, you left it at the lesson. Okay.
So the other rhythms, the Dr. Suzuki, they don't. So
back up.
Okay.
So with the gaps.
Yes.
Between.
So da 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 rest rest da 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 rest rest da 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 da. Do you want to look at the book one?
Okay. Yes.
Yes, I'll just go and grab mine.
Yes, and with the recording.
Is it available? Is she recording this?
I don't remember, but we should
tell
her, because last time
I know.
it wasn't recording.
Okay, are you recording this?
Yeah.
Because you did turn it off at one point.
I always turn the brightness down because I don't want to look at myself.
Oh, no,
it is recording. 9 minutes in.
Good.
Okay, so we do page 21, everyone. First time, one at a time for a credit. Then, rest. Repeat, so four times with rest, and we do this as a credit.
Mm-hmm.
And then four times in a row for a credit.
Yeah.
And then some people at that point
mm-hmm.
will play, and they will have a go all the way through. All the way through is 24 times. It's unlikely that your student, after maybe, two lessons or three lessons of putting the bow in this on the string and playing, is going to be able to keep it right all the way through. Mm-hmm. So for me, that comes much later. In fact, I don't think that I give a specific credit for playing it all the way through on opening. No, I don't. I mean, it is something that I do, but it's not something that is a landmark sort of thing they have to succeed at.
Is it a good idea, this is a question about, because obviously for the twinkle it's very long for them to be doing everybody busy stop all the time, but can we, because the, I don't know what's the other name, but for the monkey song, it's A string.
I call it exploring the A string or exploring the E string.
But that comes very late.
Much later, yeah.
It's like the
also,
stage.
They will be in group. They will play in a group. They will scrub away on the E string or the A string while the
okay.
other children play with their
but
fingers.
Can we do that like 8 times at the beginning?
Yeah,
because
you can do whatever you like. You can do whatever you like. Yes, you can, absolutely. I think... yeah, for me, I want them to do 4 in a row really well. And then more than that, fine, you know, it's up to you. If you want to set them a task of doing it for longer, that's fine. And if you don't, that's also fine.
So, because I've always been a bit confused with this 21, because it says all variations on E once in this order. I know it's not in that order straight away. But so you get them, say, the first lesson to do busy, stop, 4 times, come back and be able to do that. And then you teach them.
Yeah, so that will take several weeks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that maybe target one variation of
one at a time, yeah.
Yeah. And 4 times is a good aim, is it? To be able to do it 4 times.
Yeah, 4 times with rest for a credit and 4
yeah.
times without rest for a credit.
Okay.
So that like the first line of actual music on a stave on page 21.
Yeah.
Good. Then Jacqueline, next thing.
Just a second.
Sorry.
So they are doing it already 4 times without pressing the E string, right?
Yeah.
So then we go to the A string, and before we go to the A string, we explain to them. So for the string crossing, will be hand when we're going up, and when it's down, it's the elbow.
Very good. But we're not really practicing string crossing as its own skill until
yeah.
they've got used to the A for a bit.
Okay.
Because otherwise, if they get the right movement, but they can't actually stay on the A string, then it's just they will just get confused.
So we don't do the yeah.
Yeah, explain it. That's
okay.
Perfect, but not rock and roll and
no,
seesaw. It's
okay.
Not yet.
Okay.
Great. So then the same thing on the A string for
okay.
the variations, and then Sarah, when you finish writing, your turn.
Okay. Then do we do rock and roll?
Yeah, perfect.
Rock and roll and another thing, seesaw.
Yeah, great.
So we do that, and then we do variations four on E and 4 on A. Maybe not, I don't know.
It's not quite 4 on E and 4 on A, because that's what they've just done, isn't it?
Oh, so maybe...
You can look at your book if you
okay.
need to. If you need to cheat. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So you're practicing the string crossing. Da 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 change string. Da 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 change string. Da 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 da. And then without the rests. So it's the same format, but with the string crossing in between. And then Iram, they are ready for
fingering.
Woo!
First, well,
so
waterfall.
Great.
And then introduce the fingers.
Yep.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
A on A string, then E string, and then A to E. And the monkey song.
Yeah.
Before it, like, I'm a little monkey.
Yeah, or the, yeah.
Something
the,
like that.
I call it exploring the E and exploring
the
A.
And
you might need, for some children, an extra step before this. especially if they're really young or if they have, you know, motor neuron sort of, not even like official difficulties like a disability or something, but you know, if they find, like my daughter found it very difficult to know which finger was which, like she could look at them and she goes 1, 2, 3, 4, even when she was 3, but she couldn't, if you said like wiggle your 2, she was like. So lots of them, it's not on the list because we can't put everything on the list,
mm-hmm.
but lots of them will benefit from like finger one, where are you? Here I am, and how do you do? And I always do finger one, finger two, tricky three, because that's the one they find really hard to find, and then easy four. So that's a good little song to do, and then you just do like a quiz, like 3, 1, and you know, that will help them, and they can play that with their parents walking to school or whatever. It's nice to give them little things they can do away from the violin as part of practice.
Hmm.
Do you have a question, Duncan?
Yes. So before they do the waterfall, while they are practicing, like for some weeks, the string classic,
yeah.
Can they do the shape on the thing?
Shoulder.
Yeah. Here.
On the shoulder, and also I would say that they can practice putting their fingers down before they actually make a sound. Can you keep it down while we count to 10? Can you put a raisin on each finger? Can you, you know?
So like each day or each week we can practice one finger specifically. So now we'll have one down.
No, so they're not ever putting 2 down by itself at the moment. This is only away from the violin. You would always are in order.
Okay, so can we do this and then 2
yeah.
will be like that? 3?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I
is
personally
that where we do the best friend, like 1, 2, or just when we are doing the song.
So they will have the spots on the shoulder.
Yeah.
So they will have practiced that already,
mm-hmm.
and then when they come to the actual finger, they will have the stripes. So you always put them in the right place,
okay.
right pattern. I would recommend that you teach them how to put all of the fingers down one lesson. Not 1, 1, 2 a week later,
mm.
1, 2, 3, because then this is 3 weeks of the 4 being away and you might have that.
Mm.
Whereas when you put them all down straight away, you get a good hand position.
Like my pinky. My pinky always like that.
But it's better than that. That's the other problem.
Not really. It's like,
Yeah. Have I shown you those stupid things I've got for pencils?
Ah, yeah, then we'll go
like,
the giraffe.
Yeah,
that's really nice.
Or a finger puppet. Yeah. Okay, good. So we're not doing every step, but that is the getting ready for fingers step. So we do exploring the A string. Exploring the A string. Some people want to do an A major scale. But if you do it now, you have to put a stop on E descending for 1, 2, 3,
mm-hmm.
and then come down. So I leave it until later, once they've learned independent fingers, so that they can just play it in time.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. So I can't remember whose turn it is.
I think it's mine.
Your turn. Okay, so we have done exploring the E, exploring the A. What do we do next?
We are doing in all the rhythms apart from. Oh, okay. Now is the next one. No.
In exploring the E string.
No, exploring the E string. No, then you have to go to the A string, right?
Yes. And then what do they learn next?
The next rhythm.
Bread. So exploring the E and exploring the A, just busy, busy, stop, stop.
Okay.
Is what I do.
Ah, no. The.
Oh!
Secret
fingers. But not yet, because we haven't learnt the 8 notes in bread of Twinkle.
Ah, so bread.
So bread. So the first eight notes of Twinkle, because Twinkle is a sandwich, the first eight notes and then the middle four, or middle eight, and then the last eight are the same as the first eight, so we call it a Twinkle sandwich.
But how can you do bread, the second half of bread, till you've done the secret fingers?
That is exactly what we do now.
Yeah.
Oh.
So they do da 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 da
da da da
da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da
da da da da da.
But you don't do silent secret fingers first, or something.
You can, yeah, you can, absolutely. I guess this is the difference between doing this, like this level of 40 steps and the broader brush strokes. Yes.
Anyway, we've kind of done it because you were just talking about it, where you put them all down in one.
Yeah. So they do their secret fingers either during learning bread or before learning bread, and then learn bread. Excellent. And then.
So be making the gap is
not yet. So they've done it in busy stop bread,
but from the making the gap from the first bit of bread from the second bit. So take, so they will do the secret finger, right?
Yeah,
that will take longer. So the next step would be practicing that and getting the gap smaller so they can do me right away.
No. Sorry.
No!
We want to leave them with that space for a long time, because you do not want them to try and do their secret fingers really quickly, because they will just shove the fingers down on the string and they won't go 1, 2, 3, they'll go plop, and the two will probably be on C.
Okay.
There must be a name for the half quarter tone between C natural and C sharp. The C nat sharp. Anyway, so what we want is to close the other gaps. Drop. You don't want them to try and do. Idea that 1, 2, 3 is in a gap, and it is slow and careful all the way through all of their variations. So apart from Dr. Suzuki, they do all the variations like that for a credit. That's
okay.
The next stage.
Okay.
Good. Sarah, when you finish writing.
And then when they've done it, they do the park bench story.
Very good. Excellent. And the park bench story.
Yeah.
Do you remember it? Do you want me to tell you it?
Yes.
Yeah? So, well, one of you two can do it because we've done it lots of times.
Right.
Do you want to grow my violin?
Yeah. Be interesting. So, I might not get this right.
That's okay. That's what training is for.
Okay. So, you, instead of doing secret fingers, are you going to...
Okay, so not yet. Just do the park bench story in and of itself, not as part of Twinkle Bread.
Okay, so there was Mr. Finger 3. He came along and he sat down on a park bench. And
then you play it.
And then, then along came Finger 2, who was a really close friend of his, sat down on the park bench next to him. They had a good old chat.
What else did they have? Because they're best friends.
Hug.
Yeah.
They had a hug. Yeah. And they then Mr. 3 said, "Oh my goodness, look at the time, I need to go." And off he went. Bye bye. He lifted himself a little bit up. And then along came Mr. Finger 1. And he sat down on the park bench, but he wasn't such a good friend of Mr. Finger 2, just knew him a bit. So they sat not next to each other, had a good chat.
Done that.
No. Okay, all right, so and then suddenly Mr. Finger 2 looked at the time and he went away. He said, "Oh my goodness, I've got an appointment, I'm ran off." And then there's Mr. Finger 1 all on his own. Yep, and that's it.
And he said, "Oh, I'm so bored, nobody's coming to see me.
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna go as well."
Right, he said, "Oh yeah, I'm so bored. No one's coming to me, I'm gonna go." That's it.
Because
yeah,
then you get here as well.
Yeah. That's a nice violin. Oh, maybe later.
Okay.
I would like to.
Yeah,
I'm
you're
looking
welcome
for
to. Very good. So, the only loving feedback I would give you is it's interesting to make them all men, given especially that you're a woman.
Oh, it's because I was watching before I came here. There's Rachel. What's her name? Rachel Cooper. Do you know her?
Yeah.
Well, she has these things, and she always talks about Mr. Finger too.
Oh, really?
One. So
it's really interesting. Anyway, I try very hard to say finger three, finger two, and they said. And then it's completely gender neutral.
Oh, okay, right.
But that is my own, you know, agenda. I'll own it. But otherwise, very good. Yeah. So the point is that you are putting the three by itself. You are touching with the two, and then you release the three. You're feeling one and two on together, and then you release the two, and then the one obviously doesn't have anyone to feel with it this time, and goes off. So once they've learned how to do that, then they can start to do their the whole twinkle doing independent fingers, full twinkle variations, not Dr. Suzuki, but everything else is in place.
But we do all the fingers, all of them. We'll do all the rhythms before we do the cheese, right?
Before yeah,
we do all
bread.
The bread with all the rhythms.
Except Dr. Suzuki.
Exactly.
Yes.
Before doing the cheese, okay.
Yeah. And you would be tapping three, and you'll see when you look at the full list, you know, you're tapping three ahead of time. You are,
yeah,
you know, you're the park bench story you introduce while they're doing the bread, you know, reviews and things. And they would be doing this as a box. So they're practicing this. You need the one, because otherwise they'll just... to go from here, get ready.
Yeah.
So they're practicing that preparing drop, tip and drop at the same time. And then you're practicing tapping twos, ready for lightly row, and off we go. We can do all our twinkles and we're ready for the rest of book one.
One thing I'm always curious about, when you put finger three down, do you expect them to be able to play the E string while finger three is down?
No, I want them at this stage. I want them, that's why I do this as the box. Prepare, plop and drop is what I call it.
Yeah.
Plop and drop. So the finger plops and the bow drops to the A.
Yeah. Yeah, because I've tried to get them to do it in advance and then they mute.
Yeah, they catch the E.
So it's not being expected.
Right.
Okay, good.
I mean, yeah, I don't think so. Some people, like for instance, in lightly row, will be very keen to teach the two staying down there. I don't personally think there's that much interest in that, because either they're practicing, which is good to make sure there's a tunnel, good left hand shape, that's great, or which is helping them place the finger accurately. I think both of those things are equally useful, so I don't really make a fuss about which one they're doing. Okay, so to finish off, we're gonna actually look at the pre-twinkle list. It's on the group chat if you don't have it. And just have a look at what we haven't covered, because we've done the broad brush strokes, but not the whole thing. And so I'm just gonna read them out and you're gonna stop me if there's something you want me to remind you about, okay? Or if you have a question, yeah? Okay, so the thing that we didn't talk about, and it's fine because I didn't make it clear, but we do want to keep in mind, is the parent education. That we are always talking to the parents about how they're doing practice, about the philosophy of Suzuki, about how they can stay positive with their children, about all of these things that we have spent hours and hours talking about, and that we need to remember to just drip feed them all the time.
Yeah.
And then parts of the violin and bow pictures, credits for knowing those things, concert position with violin and the bow on the floor, rest position with violin and bow. So that's the violin in rest position and the bow on the finger.
Is it really, because I keep forgetting to ask you, with concert position, is there a very strict way that the bow has to go round in violin?
Yeah, you need this. You need the scroll and the tip together. Otherwise, when they pick it up, they have to go like that.
Okay.
Then feet positions, playing in rest position feet. By the way, how do we have our feet when we do a proper Suzuki bow? So one thing we haven't talked about yet, introduce the high and low notes with the second note game.
Yeah.
So like da da, da da, da da. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone
yeah.
remember the game?
Yeah.
Good. Bow hold bunny.
Oh yes, before.
And then make a bow hold for them and see if they can keep it. And then teach the parent how to help them make the bow hold, and then they make the bow hold themselves.
Mm-hmm.
That's quite a big, 8 to 10 is quite a big chunk of work. And then a twinkle rhythm singing bread with hand signs for pitch, so maybe busy, busy, stop, stop, busy, busy, stop, stop, busy, busy, stop, stop, or busy, you know, whichever one you feel good about. Soaping the rhythms on the upper left arm. Turn and tip in the air onto the violin, and air and then onto the violin.
And we didn't do that.
Yeah, but that's fine because we were talking big picture,
yeah.
not small picture. But remember, when we do turn and tip in the air, could you come here so it's on the video? We are taking the hands so that they're not twisting away,
mm-hmm.
and you turn to your imaginary violin,
mm-hmm.
and then drop your head. Beautiful. And
mm-hmm.
10 of those.
Okay.
Stop the traffic. Pop three ways. Are we all clear on the three ways to do pop?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah?
Uh-huh.
Helicopters onto the shoulder. Another twinkle variation. Singing with the signs.
Do you do twinkle variations on the shoulder?
Sometimes.
I quite like that.
Yeah.
Question.
Yes.
Do you think it's confusing for the kids? Because I do fingerings a lot for memory, right? For helping them with memory, so we'll do that.
But what do you mean we'll do that?
Like, but then sometimes, I don't know if it's confusing, because when we play like this. And when we are just, when I'm teaching, like, memory is like this and not like that.
I don't think it's that confusing, but you could always just do it like this way.
But
then,
and then they're practicing the same thing.
There
is a thing that here, it's very not polite to do that, right? Because there was one day I did that.
Yeah.
And one of the teachers then told me, oh, you shouldn't do that.
Oh, no, I do that, and actually the children.
So I'm always like this because of that. So
yeah.
No, their playing is more important than what.
I think.
Yeah.
But I was really because I said why. I said because it's rude.
But yeah, it's just an impolite gesture.
I do that.
But maybe you could also do like, touch the finger you're gonna put down.
Okay.
I mean, it comes with its own problems because then it encourages the thumb to come around, so.
Okay.
There's no perfect way. Okay, we have 3 minutes to get to the end. Right, make a bow hold themselves. Teacher or parent puts the violin on the shoulder, land the bow, play busy, busy, stop, stop on E. Have we already done helicopters? Yeah, good.
Yeah.
Check the student can make a bow hold with the violin in rest position. Then, the whole sort of setup, and you can also even start this from concert position, rest position, bow hold, stop the traffic, helicopters onto the E string. And then you are ready to start playing on your violin. Woohoo! One at a time, as we talked about going through them. Introduce seesaw and rock and roll. Oh, that's interesting. We didn't think that that was what was it said, did we?
No.
Maybe it isn't.
I mean, it's one of those things that. It's a bit chicken and egg, isn't it? If you can't do the string crossing, you can't get to the A. But if you can't play on the A string for four notes in a row, what's the point in going to A? So you have to do them concurrently, really.
Seems to me the first thing you said was better, learning, really consolidating the A string, because they like to do this anyway. And they then
yeah,
mine always want to play on the G.
Yeah, I'm actually quite keen on them playing on the G as well, because it means that they can practice that thing of always having the elbow lower than the hand.
Yeah.
Okay, land on E, tip to A, play rhythm with rest and without on A four times. Finding the waterfall, umbrella fingers over strings. Moving E to A with rest, same without rest, exploring the E string, exploring the A string. I'm going very fast because we just spent a lot of time on this, is this okay? Yes, good. Secret fingers. Bread with secret fingers, a credit for each variation. Yes. Tapping three, and then the box that I was just talking about. Park bench story, walking fingers, E321, walking fingers in bread and cheese, tapping two during twinkles, playing E to A2 during twinkles, full twinkles, off we go, and we still have 30 seconds for any questions. Does anyone have any questions? No, good, thank you very much.
For the credit one, it was a tap three, busy, busy, stop, stop, right? And then 1-0, like, five,
yeah.
Two. It's that one, the box, right?
Yeah. Great, and if you look at this, this is just a kind of different way of seeing how that might fit into your year of learning for ideally year, sometimes 2 years, sometimes 3 years.
Yeah.
And just have a look at the back or the second sheet as well, because it's got a bit of an explanation. Brilliant, okay.
Two sheets, yeah. Right.
But I don't have that one.
Okay, you do now. You have it?
I don't know if it's the... Which one is that? Which year is that?
I don't know.
Teacher's aid, rough teaching plan for first year of Suzuki.
I've only got one.
Yeah, it's those two sheets. It's just this is double-sided and those are not.
Oh, so that's like you don't need one, but...
You don't. This is what I printed out and brought you this morning. Yeah.
Is
I just didn't realise I had spares here.
Which year is it? Because
it doesn't say. I took it off because it was rubbish.
So it's the same?
I think so.
Okay. So
do you want this copy instead? This is very exciting for anyone watching at home. Thanks for watching. Rate, subscribe, and whatever the other thing you're supposed to do is like.